Welcome to the video lecture series of Digital Image Processing. Today's topic is Image Compression Model. So after the completion of today's lecture, you will be able to understand how to draw the image compression model. You can explain what is image compression, why it is required, and what are the application areas. Let us begin. First, let me tell you what is image compression. And I am very much sure that you are aware with this particular term because you are dealing with the compression in your daily life. While you are playing with your phone, sometimes you used to click a photograph, you make a video, and if you would like to share it with your friend, then sometimes you say that the size of image is very large, I am not able to share it. Video is very large, let me reduce it. So what you would like to do, you would like to reduce the size of an image or the video and then you share it with the others. This is what? This is nothing but image compression. So image compression, this is a very important concept in the case of image processing. And images and videos requires lots of space for the storage. At the same time, if the size of image and video is very large, obviously it takes long time for the transmission and it will give the bandwidth constraint as well. Therefore, image compression or compression is necessary for both storage and transmission. So, how can you explain a term data compression? Data compression is the process of encoding data so that it takes less storage time and less transmission time in comparison to the original one data. This is what the data compression. Mathematically, data compression can be represented as a process of transforming data to a smaller representation of the original. What do you mean by this? If we say original data consists of n1 bits and compressed data consists of n2 bits. Means in this original data, compression is being applied and now you are getting the compressed data which will consist of n2 bits. So obviously if you are applying compression, it means n2 must be less than n1. Then only the compression is being applied. So this is the second case. If n2 is less than n1, it means there is a significant compression. But what would you say if n1 is equal to n2? Means the number of bits in the original data is same as the number of bits in the compressed data. It means you are going to say there is no compression. At the same time, if let us assume and discuss this possibility as well. If number of bits means which is n2, this is higher than the n1. What you are going to say? Initially bits was less, now it has been increased. It means this is the case of data explosion. This you need not to study over here because here we are concerned with the image compression. It means n2 must be less than n1. If we talk about the data and information, so data and information are two different things. Means data is a raw fact which you can observe and which are encountered in the image processing, while information is what? Information is the interpretation of data in some meaningful way. Therefore, you can say that data is the means by which information is conveyed. So this is how you can understand what is data and what is information and how to explain it. And the types of data that are encountered in image processing, it can be known as a multimedia data. So that is the multimedia data, and multimedia data can include a number of things. So let us discuss types of data which is actually encountered in image processing, and you know that now it is known as a multimedia data. So it consists of text data. First one, text data is what? Text data, it is present in flat files and it can be read and understood by human beings. Means we people can easily read it, we people can easily understand the text data. Second is the binary data. Binary data is actually interpreted by the machines only, like metadata which is present in the database files. So this is about the binary data. Third is the image data. What is image data? You have studied the image, how to represent it. So you have studied image can be represented into a form of the matrix, and image consists of the pixels. So image data is the pixel data, and it contains intensity and color information of the image. Next type of data is graphics data. Graphics data means you have studied graphics representation, vector representation, raster representation of the image. So graphics is what? It is in the vector form. Next type of data which can be like found in image processing is sound data. Sound is what? This is the audio information, and video data represents the video information. So these are all the types of data that can be encountered in any image processing, and you must be able to explain all of these terms. I hope now it must be clear to you. Since image processing applications has huge amount of image data, so that is what the whole of the thing is, means playing with the data here. Now let us discuss why data compression is essential. Why to do the data compression? There are three factors. Data compression is required because of these three factors: storage, transmission, and faster computation. So storage is what? Storage requirement, whenever you need to store the image or video. So storage requirement for the imaging applications must be very high, and here the objective is to perform the data compression. Why? Because the storage requirement can be reduced. Means if initially there is a requirement of 10 MB to store certain data, after compression it may be 6 or 4. This is just an example. It means minimum data must be stored somewhere, so that from that particular data original information can be extracted accurately. So the reduction in data actually reduces the memory requirement, and therefore resources spent for the storage. Means obviously it depends on the amount as well, how much you are spending over there. Second factor is the transmission. What is this transmission? How data compression is related with this? So the transmission time of the image is actually directly proportional to the size of the image. If size of image is large, transmission time will be large. Size of image is less, transmission time will be less. Therefore, image compression objective is to reduce the transmission time, if and only if we are going to reduce the image size. Third is the faster computation. Faster computation means reduce data sometimes simplifies the algorithm's design. And if it simplifies the algorithm designs, then definitely it will facilitate faster execution of the programs. So these are the three reasons why data compression is required. Now let us discuss some of the applications of data compression. Applications are in personal communication, like voicemail, telephony, in case of computer networks like internet, in multimedia applications, in the applications of image and signal processing, digital and satellite television, video conferencing, digital library. These are all the applications of the data compression. There are some other applications, you can write it them as well. I have listed some of the applications over here. Now let us discuss the compression scheme. You can see a block diagram which shows the compression scheme over here. Here you can see there are two things, compression and decompression algorithms. See, compression algorithms and decompression algorithms. Input for this block means for the sampling quantizer must be what? Visual information. Visual information, and output will be original information. See, so here compression and decompression algorithms are for what? This is actually nothing but the compressor and decompressor. First information is compressed and after at the receiving end it is decompressed so that you can get the original information. And these may be located at the same place or at both the ends. Means compressor at the transmitter side and decompressor at the receiver side. This compression and decompressor are also known as coder and decoder. Coder and decoder. Here the term coder or encoder can be written over here. So coder and decoder are collectively known as codec. And codec may be a hardware or the software components. So this is how a compression scheme can be understood. Now, the two main components of image compressor models. What are these two main components? Encoder and decoder. As I have told you, encoder is for the compression algorithms and decoder is for the decompression algorithms. So, image compression model can be drawn like this particular diagram. Let me say if input is f of xy and output is, let us write, f cap of xy. Here f and f cap must be same. It must be as near as possible. See, in this particular diagram you can see there is a source encoder, channel encoder, then channel, and after that channel decoder and source decoder. This source or symbol encoder, this takes a set of symbols from the input data. Input data is what? Fxy. And it removes the redundancy. This does what? It removes redundancy and send the data across the channel. What does channel encoder does? It increases noise immunity. It increases noise immunity, and after that the data is being sent across the channel which is available over here. And this decoder has two parts, namely channel decoder and source decoder. You can see over here. So the channel decoder and source and decoder, this performs the inverse operation. If the link is noise free, in case of noise free link, these two parts, channel encoder and decoder, can be omitted. Means you can note it down here. If link is noise free, then channel encoder and decoder can be omitted, because their objective is to handle with the noise immunity. So if noise is not present, if link is noise free, so these two blocks can be omitted. Now let us discuss the stages of encoding. You can see there are three stages of the encoding. First is mapper, second is quantizer, and third is the symbol encoder. What is the function of this mapper? This mapper transforms, okay, once again you can write input for the mapper is what? Fxy, and output you can write fxy or fcap. So what is the function of this mapper? Mapper transforms input data format designed to reduce what? Designed to reduce the interpixel redundancies in input image. It reduces interpixel redundancy in the input message, and this is reversible operation. You can note down these points. And mapper may or may not reduce the amount of data which is required to represent the image. It's not mandatory that it is going to reduce the amount of data. Second is the quantizer. Quantizer, it actually reduces the accuracy of mapper output. At the same time, it reduces psycho-visual redundancy. What is psycho-visual redundancy? Which a human observer can easily identify and can reduce it. It is not a reversible operation. And it must be omitted when error-free or lossless compression is desired. Third is the symbol encoder. So symbol encoder does what? Symbol encoder's main function is to create a fixed or variable length code. This is the main function of the symbol encoder, and it maps the output accordingly with the code, and in most of the cases variable length codes are used and this is a reversible operation. So these are the three stages of the encoding. Next is the source decoder. Source decoder consists of two components, main component source decoder and inverse mapper. It performs the reverse operation, and the inverse operation of source encoder, symbol encoder and mapper block. And the inverse for the quantizer has been left out over here. So this is how the inverse operation is being carried out, and at the end means here. So this particular information, this is being transmitted through the channel in case of the encoding. And here what is the input? Input will be received from the channel, and after decoding and inverse mapping you will be able to extract the original information, which is the XY. So I hope now the stages of encoding and decoding process is also clear to you. Topic for the next video lecture is compression measures. Thank you so much for watching this video.